In this session, we'll start work on our corridor model. We're going to be building this first piece here. We're going to do it in two halves. If I zoom in, we can see that I have a traffic separator here coming up to this median area. For right now, we're going to build everything up to the median. Let me hover right here. This is where I have my PGL on the right side. This is what I'm going to be sweeping my alignment along. This is going to be driving the horizontal and vertical aspect of the right side lanes. There's going to be three lanes on the right, and then there'll be three lanes on the left. Let's build the assembly. I'll do that here on the Home tab in the Create Design panel. I'll open the Assembly menu. I'll choose Create Assembly. I'm going to call this SR7-Traffic Separator. Assembly type is going to be divided. I'm going to keep the default styles here, and I'll click OK. And then I'll click to place this on screen. Now let's add some lanes. I'll do that by selecting the assembly, and then I'll come up and click the Tool Palette button. And then I'm going to right-click on the palette name, and I'll come down and choose F.Subassemblies. I'll choose the Lanes tab, and I'm going to add an F.Lane. I'll click the insertion marker here on the right side. We'll add that lane. Now we'll adjust its properties. I'm going to select the lane, and I'll come over to the Properties palette. Mine's anchored to the interface. If yours is not on screen, you can always press Control-1 to bring this up. I'm going to call this right lane number 1. Very important to give your subassembly parts logical names. Comes in real handy later on when we're assigning targets. The lane width is good, slope is good. Super elevation type, I don't have super elevation on this alignment right now, but in the event I add it later, this would represent a right inside lane. Let's take care of our pavement depths. Pavement depth 1 is 1.5 inches, pavement depth 2 is 1.5 inches, base depth is going to be 6 inches, and sub-base depth will make that 4. Let me press Escape. That looks good. Let's create the next lane. I'm going to copy this one. I'll select the lane, and I'll come up and choose Copy. And then I'll click the marker to snap this to the edge of traveled way on the right side. I will then select this lane. We'll adjust its properties. This will be right lane number 2. All the rest of the settings are good. Let's create the next lane over. I'll create a copy. I'll just select this lane. Copy. We'll snap that to the outside ring. I'll select this lane, and then we'll adjust its properties. This is going to be right lane outside. Let me drag this down. I'm going to make this a slope of -3%, and we'll say in the event we use super elevation, this will represent a right outside lane. There we go. Let's add some curb and gutter. I'm going to go to the Curb and Gutter tab, and I'll choose Type F Curb. We'll connect that to the outside. One of the nice things about the Florida DOT curb assemblies, if I select this and go to my Properties palette, you can see right down here, I've chosen a Type F curb. There are other options here. If I select another option, you can see how that geometry changes. Let me flip that back to Type F. Perfect. Let me give this a logical name. I'm going to select it, and I'll call this right curb gutter outside. Finally, I'm going to add the curb to the inside. This is going to be a Type D curb up against the traffic separator. Let me select that, and then I'll click this marker on the inside. Now, I put it on the wrong side. One day, we'll be able to select the part and then go over to the Properties palette and change its side parameter right here. Today's not that day. I'm doing this to show you that if you select the object and go to Subassembly Properties, here on the Parameters tab, you get access to all the same settings that we see in the Properties palette, although we can change the side here. If I open this up, I can choose Left. In fact, I can go to Information, I can name this one too. We'll call this Right Curb Inside. All right, let me deselect that. So I've got my right side part of my assembly built out. Remember, this is going to be swept along the PGL on the right side. Let's go ahead and build the corridor based on what we have right now. I'm going to launch the corridor command. I'm going to call this corridor SR7. The alignment that we're going to be following is PGL right. I will be following the PGL right proposed profile. I'm going to be using my SR7 traffic separator I just made. I'm not targeting any surfaces. I am going to leave the set baseline and region parameter setting selected because I do want the dialog box. Let me click OK. I wanted this because I want to adjust the start and end station of the region. I'm not going to be sweeping this assembly the entire length of this alignment. Let's take the region that I have here, and we're going to adjust the start station. I'll click the Select button, and I'd like my region to start here, right at the end of the traffic separator. and I'd like the end station. Let me click the select button. I'd like that to be right here at the bend. This represents where we switch from a type D to a type F curb. Let's go ahead and click OK and we'll rebuild based on what we have right now. This looks pretty good. Although right here, this alignment represents the edge of traveled way on the right side, I would like this rightmost lane to be pulled over to match that alignment. So let's adjust the target here. I'm going to select the corridor. I'll go to corridor properties. We'll go to parameters. We'll take the region that we just built. I'm going to come down and click the target ellipsis button. Here's where the logical naming comes in handy. I would like to assign a horizontal target to the right lane outside. Let me click in that field. I'd like to target an alignment, and I'm going to target this one called Edge of Traveled Way Right. Now, you can either click your targets from here, or if you want to pick them from the drawing, you can click the green block and then select them on screen. Let me click Add. I'll click OK, OK, OK. Let's rebuild. Perfect. I do want to do one more thing. We can see this inside most right lane. The edge of pavement is right here. I'd like this to be pulled over to meet this right side median edge. So I'd like this lane to target something on the left. Unfortunately, the lane subassembly that I chose does not support that. Let's make a change to our assembly. I'm going to right-click on the tool palette and I'll come up to Civil Imperial Subassemblies. From here, I'll choose the Lanes tab and I'm going to select this lane from tapered median. That's exactly what this subassembly part was made for. Let me click Help for a second. I'll pan this down and you can see right here, this lane will follow the PGL or the assembly like it's supposed to, but if it targets something on the left, you can see that it'll pull over while maintaining that same slope. You can see that right here. If I drag this down, you can see that this lane is a perfect choice to use in the event you're trying to tie to a median edge. So I'm going to use this one. Let me click to select it. I'm going to choose Replace, and I'll select the subassembly part I want to replace. I'll press Escape a couple times when finished. Now that I've added a new part, we need to adjust its properties. Let me select it. I'll go to the Properties palette, and I'll call this right lane number one. Let me drag this down. As far as super elevation slope, this is going to be right inside lane. If I get to the bottom here, you can see that Civil 3D takes care of the pavement depths in feet. Not a problem, I can do the math right here. I want my pavement one depth to be 1.5 inches, so I'll type equals 1.5 divided by 12, and I'll press Alt-Enter to calculate that value. I'll press Enter to go to the next field. This one's going to be equals 1.5 divided by 12. Alt-Enter, we'll go to the next one. My base depth is going to be 6 inches, equals 6 divided by 12. Alt-Enter, we'll go down to the next one. The sub-base is going to be 4 inches, equals 4 divided by 12. Alt-Enter. Perfect, that lane's ready to go. Let's come back over and we'll adjust our corridor targets. Let me select the corridor. I'll go to Corridor Properties, and then we'll come down to Target. And I can see that the right lane number one supports two targets, one for the width and one for the median edge. I'm going to click in the median edge target, and I would like you to target an alignment. You're going to target the median on the right side. Let me click Add. Okay. 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 Let's rebuild. That is perfect. That's exactly what I want to see. That is until I get down here to the end. You can see it's doing exactly what it's supposed to. It's targeting that median edge, but when it gets down here, it's pulling over because that median edge pulls out to this corner. I'm going to fix this by pulling the end of this region back just a couple hundredths. Corridor is still selected. Let me go to Corridor Properties. I'll come down and let's change the end station. I'm going to click here and we'll change this from 19.90 to 19.87. We'll pull it back 3/100. I'll click OK. I'll choose Rebuild. There we go. That looks good. Okay, so we've got the right side lanes taken care of. Now let's look at the left side. The left side lanes need to follow this PGL over here. So they have to move independently of the right side. So you might think we almost need another assembly to do that. Let me show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to pan this over. And then I'm going to come down to the Generic tab. And I'm going to choose Link, Width, and Slope. Let's go to the Properties palette, and I want to pick my side. Let me make sure this is set to left. I will then select my insertion marker. Now, the reason why I picked the link width and slope is because I can assign a horizontal and a vertical target to this point. I'm going to match this to the PGL left, horizontal alignment and profile. That way I can build my leftmost lanes on this marker and they will have independent control over what's going on the right side. Right side follows PGL right, left side's going to follow PGL left. So this line is essentially a schematic at this point. Since it's schematic, let me select it. I'll come over here to the properties palette and I'm going to make it a little bit longer. Let's make this 15 feet long. Let's make the slope 0 and we'll call this PGL left. That's what that point represents. In fact, let's name the marker or the line itself. So when we assign targeting, we'll call this PGL left link. Now I can simply build my leftmost lanes on this marker. Fortunately, I don't have to build them from scratch. I can just mirror these. I'm going to select these. Let me click this inside curb. I'll choose mirror. And I'll select my PGL left marker. There we go. All we have to do is rename these now. Let me select this first one. This one's going to be left. All of these will be left. The time spent renaming these pays dividends later when you go through and have to assign targets. It only takes a second to rename them and it just makes things so much easier to understand when we're assigning targets. Last one. Let me make an adjustment too for our super elevation slopes. This one is not a right inside lane. This is going to be a left inside, as will this one. This one's going to be a left inside lane, and then finally this one will be a left outside lane. Okay, let's rebuild the corridor based on what we have right now. I'll select the corridor and I'll just come up and click rebuild. There we go, we can see the left lanes going in. Now, if we look right here, we can see the distance between my curb is the same distance as my schematic link that I have here. That's because the point here at the end is not yet tied to the PGL on the left side. So I've got some targeting I have to do. I've got to take care of the left outside lane, has to target this edge, and this lane, this first inside left lane, needs to target this median edge on the inside. So let's take care of our targeting. Corridor still selected. Let me go to corridor properties. I'm going to come down and click the target button. Let's take care of the PGL left link. I would like this to follow my PGL left alignment. Remember, this is also a vertical target. Let's come down to PGL left link. We would like that to follow a profile. I'd like it to follow the profile associated with the PGL left alignment. We'll follow PGL left proposed profile. Let me click add. And I'll click OK. So now the left lanes are going to be independently controlled of the right lanes. Let's take care of our other targets. Lane left outside. I want you to target the edge of traveled way on the left. And then I want the left lane median edge. I want you to follow the median left alignment. Let me click OK and OK. And okay, we'll rebuild the corridor. There we go, that looks really good. Just for a second, let's take a look at this in the section editor. I'm going to select the corridor. I'll click section editor. We can see this. We can take and click to walk through the various stations. One nice thing about the section editor, I can see my alignments. Here's my alignment on the edge of traveled way left, edge of traveled way right. These brown ones represent my medians, so as I walk through this, I can make sure that my targeting is correct. One thing that I do see in here is my subassembly link, my little schematic link. I don't need to see that. Let me click close. Let me come over here. I'm going to select that link. That's why we have the opportunity down here. We can choose omit link. I could set that to yes. Now that I've done that, let me select my corridor and I'll choose rebuild. And you can see those connections are no longer there. Let me select this again and I'll go back to the section editor. I'm going to zoom in on my traffic separator, and then I'm going to come over and I'm going to expand the menu here. I just want to make sure that we choose zoom to an offset and elevation. That'll kind of lock this view on screen. So now each time I click next, it won't zoom out and do a zoom extents. So I'm good. Everything's moving like it should. Everything's following the alignments and profiles that it should. I just want to connect the dots here. Let's look at how we can do that. I'm going to click close. Let me come back over to my assembly. Here on the generic tab, I'm going to choose mark point. Let's zoom in, and I'm going to place a marked point at the top back of curb. I will then give this mark point a name. Over in the properties palette, let me come down here. Point name, I'm going to call it median. Let me press escape. And then I'm going to choose link to marked point. And I'd like to place that at the top back of curb over here. Once again, just schematic. This is just a schematic object. Let me select this. And I'm going to tell this that you need to connect to the marked point called median. Perfect. So as these objects are drawn, each time the assembly is placed along the corridor and these objects are drawn, it's going to take and connect this dot to the marked point over here. Let me show you one more thing. If I select my assembly, I'm going to come up to assembly properties. We'll go to construction. Here we can see how the assembly is built. Kind of like an outline version. So there's my assembly or my baseline, and then here's my right side, my left side. If I open this up, you can see all the items that are on the right side, right lane, lane two, outside lane, curb and gutter, inside curb, and there's my marked point. Notice the marked point occurs before the link to marked point. As it inserts each of these assemblies along the corridor, it just takes and draws them based on the list. It has to draw the marked point before it does the link, otherwise it won't know where to connect to. In the event you had these reversed, I can always right click on the group and say move down. You can see now the left side is going to be drawn first. Okay, in which case this won't work because it's going to try and link to something that it hasn't drawn yet. Let me right click and I'll say move down. So we'll put that back. So in the event your link to marked point isn't working, that could be the case. Let me click OK. Let's come back over here. I'll select the corridor and we'll do a rebuild. We'll watch the area right in here. There we go. We can see how the dots are connected. Corridor selected. Let me go to section editor. Now, when I selected the corridor, I selected it from one of the longitudinal lines, so it took me to the beginning of the alignment. Let me open this menu and I'll say jump to the first region station. There we go. Let me zoom in, and I'm going to zoom to an offset and elevation. Now, as I take a step through here, we can see how those items are connected. That is until I get to the end where I run out of assembly. Let me click close. There we go. So at this point, we have our corridor model taken care of all the way up until we get to the median. In the next session, we will complete this part of the corridor by drawing the corridor in this median area.